हमारा गांव एकदम जैसे आपदा जैसी स्थिति में है इस समय। हमारी रोड भी जो गांव की लिंक रोड थी वो उसके नीचे से भी कटिंग हुई, तो रोड भी टूट चुकी है।
जो NH वाले जो रोड काट रहे हैं इन गाँव का बहुत नुकसान हो रहा है, क्योंकि हमारे जो नहरें हैं, खेती है, ये जो खेत हैं, रास्ते हैं, इन्होंने जो है पूरा नुकसान पूरा बह गया हमारा, पूरा रास्ता टूट रखा हमारा। एक रास्ता यहाँ नीचे आता है भिंगारी की ग्राम सभा बोलते हैं इधर सामने, वहाँ भी एक लड़की मलमा आया वो दब गई वहाँ पर।
Large volumes of muck being generated, and it has been haphazardly dumped because there was no EIA sought before the project was started. No such sites were identified beforehand. Now boards are being put up wherever the muck was dumped, saying these are muck dumping sites. There is rules which specify that in the mountains the road can be at maximum 8.8 meters wide with a shoulder 9.8 meters. In many places the road has been cut up to 30 meters. Okay. It's not going to last.
All weather road, it's a fooling thing, and it will not sustain in the mountains, because in the mountains you are making the roads on the fills, you are making the roads on the rocks, you are making the roads on the even on the subsided landslides. Older landslides. So every 100 meters in the mountains, it's a different landscape, it is a different substrata. And if you make a uniform policy, if you make a uniform code for making the roads in the mountains all together from Rishikesh to Kedarnath, it's not going to work there.
The faster the pilgrimage, the less people stop en route, and they don't contribute anything to the local economies, they don't stay at chattis, they don't eat at the dhabas. Locally, I do not think it is going to contribute anything at all other than a carbon footprint for the community.